嗨，观众朋友您好，欢迎收看全球趋势新闻，帮你挖掘好新闻，我是 Bonnie。 5月6号，美国陆军一名正在受训的新兵带了一把步枪逃出位于南卡罗来纳州的营区，并在路上挟持了一辆小学校车，到底怎么回事，带您来看。5月6号，新兵科拉佐逃出营区，他随身携带一把步枪，但是没有弹药。从车上监视器所拍摄的画面可以看到，科拉佐在上车之后大声向司机说：“开车，开车。”
That is just a few seconds of the 6 minutes that these kids and the bus driver were very traumatized and feared their life. They were not physically hurt.But you can just imagine how they feel and what they're going to have to live with.
不过在挟持当下，好奇的孩子开始问到了科拉佐一大堆问题，让他没办法招架。
Everything just went through my mind, and I just started freaking out. We were driving everywhere, looking like maniacs, like just trying to find that bus.
最后，科拉佐决定让车上每个人都下车，接着他开了一小段的距离，把枪留在车上，最终被逮捕。美国最大负责运输石油的输油管公司殖民管线公司在7号突然遭到骇客攻击，导致东岸长达8851公里的输油管线完全瘫痪，并且造成了民众恐慌，纷纷抢购石油。而根据了解，这次的攻击是一个骇客组织 DarkSide 所执行的，目的是要借此勒索石油管线公司。不过现在传出呢 ，DarkSide 和俄罗斯的关系匪浅，也让原本就已经很紧绷的美俄关系再次面临危机。
加油站外大排长龙，就怕晚一步车子就没油加了。这样恐慌抢油的现象发生在美国东岸纽约、休斯顿跟华盛顿特区等地。原因是全美最大的输油管线公司——殖民管线公司，在7号遭到来自俄罗斯的骇客攻击，导致全部输油管瘫痪多天，一直到12号下午5点才逐渐恢复营运。
Commute each way to work, probably about 25 miles, so it goes to rest quickly. Usually, I'm the type of person that waits until the tank's all the way on E, before I get my gas fill. But today, about a quarter of a tank, I'm topped off now. Before I get stuck, you know, having to get to work.Not having gas available or having a shortage.
Right, I got things I gotta do, things I gotta go, places I gotta do, you know. I also do Uber Eats, so I'm also an Uber Eats driver, so I also need gas for that, you know, so.
This is not a just gasoline story, that this is all of Colonial's products that are shut down, all of its main lines, whereas in 2016, it was just a gasoline pipeline that shut down for 2 weeks. This time, it's gasoline, diesel, jet fuel, all shut down,And we're seeing the ripple effects now in various portions of the transportation sector.
美国殖民管线公司有着一条长达8850公里的输油管，是东岸的重要能源动脉。每天从墨西哥湾油厂输送250万汽油到东岸各地，提供超过45%的油量。七号因为网络攻击瘫痪后，当地的汽油价格翻涨，从平均一加仑$2上下涨到超过$3，是2014年来最高的价格。
Hello, folks.I want to update everyone on the ransomware cyber attack that impacted on the Colonial Pipeline over this past week. As of yesterday evening, Colonial has begun restarting the flow of refined products in their pipeline. This morning, Colonial reported that fuel is beginning to flow to a majority of the markets that they service, and they should be reaching full operational capacity as we speak.As I speak to you right now, that is good news. But I want to be clear, we'll not feel the effects at the pump immediately. This is not like flicking on a light switch. This pipeline is 5,500 miles long. It had never been fully shut down its entire history. And so fully, and we have to, now they have to safely and fully return to normal operations.And it's going to take some time.
造成这场瘫痪事件的骇客组织 DarkSide 事发后在网络上公开承认，又接着在12号宣布攻击了另外三家公司。另外，因为组织据点在俄罗斯，也让不少人怀疑俄罗斯政府是否在幕后操纵。目前，俄罗斯官方否认涉及此事件，而联邦调查局 FBI 也还在调查这起骇客事件的真相。
一般人一辈子能爬上一次珠穆朗玛峰，也就是大家说的圣母峰，就已经非常光荣了。不过尼泊尔有一名向导在5月7号第25次登上了世界第一高峰珠穆朗玛峰，刷新了他自己先前缔造的世界纪录。现年51岁的向导瑞塔与其他11名雪巴人向导在5月7号下午6点左右登上了圣母峰，这已经是他第25次登顶了。
The, my country, people and my family also there, all happy for me.
尼泊尔官方指出，瑞塔一行人是今年首批登顶的登山者。尼泊尔政府今年向408名外国登山者发放了攀登圣母峰的许可证。去年因为新冠疫情的影响，圣母峰的南侧与北侧都被关闭。
So for I think is Mount Everest climbing easier for you? Is it easy? Not mountain is not only Everest. All mountain is not easy. Every season and every day is changing.
瑞塔从1994年开始攀登圣母峰，而且几乎每一年都会登顶一次。他在2019年曾经在不到一周的时间里两次的登上圣母峰，分别写下第23次和第24次登顶的世界纪录。美国知名的电视节目《Ellen Show》开播18季以来，一共获得了64座艾美奖，而63岁的主持人 Ellen DeGeneres 更是曾经获得前总统奥巴马所颁发的自由勋章。不过 ，Ellen 最近在节目上面宣布，将在2022年结束这个脱口秀节目。来听听 Ellen 怎么说。
Today, thank you。
露出不舍的神情，长达18年的艾伦秀即将画下句点。
I want you to know that I've thought a lot about this decision. I sat with it for a while. I meditated on it. I talked to Portia. I talked to myself. A few times I was talking to myself, and Portia thought I was talking to her. And one time I was talking to Portia, but she thought I was talking to myself because the other times when I was talking to myself, and she thought I was talking to her. And one time I was talking to Alexa, and Siri answered. And then another time I was talking to the TV, and I accidentally texted my eye doctor. The point is, I need to take a break from talking.
艾伦秀从2003年开播，红遍全美，超过3000集，更访问过2400位名人，从好莱坞巨星到美国总统，都曾接受过他的访问。2018年时，其实艾伦就想结束节目，但被电视台未留签了3年约，如今此意已决。
I always knew in my heart that season 19 would be my last. 19 is a great number.First of all, the 19th Amendment gave women the right to vote, and this may be controversial, but I believe that women should be allowed to vote. I've said it, there, I've said it. Yep. Also on the periodic table, 19 is the atomic number for potassium. You may wonder why I've decided to end after 19 seasons. The truth is, I always trust my instincts. My instinct told me it's time. As a comedian, I have always understood the importance of timing. And
去年艾伦的丑闻包括被指控是双面人、霸凌员工、耍大牌，还帮人身边好友性骚扰、种族歧视，带来极大风波。艾伦也公开道歉，不过这并不是离开最主要的理由。
In this amazing chapter, in 1997, I knew it was time to come out on my sitcom and live my truth.Back then, I had a vivid dream that a bird flew out of a cage and set itself free because it needed to get out of that cage. And recently, I had a dream that a bird, a beautiful bird with bright red feathers, came to my window and whispered, "You can still do stuff on Netflix." And that was the sign I was looking for.
外传他的好友珍妮佛·安妮斯顿可能会接棒主持，对艾伦来说，结束了这一回合，再战下一回合。
委内瑞拉不只是新冠肺炎疫情蔓延，离谱的通货膨胀问题也迟迟没有解答。这里的最低月薪只有700万玻利瓦，相当于新台币的70元，连一天三餐都买不起。于是有一些内心很痛苦的民众就来到了加拉加斯的东部，寻求心灵上的治疗。
能这么着， De hecho, nos llaman médicos porque no somos médicos, somos sanadores espirituales. ¿Entiendes? Que venimos a este plano terrenal a buscarle, a ayudar a los seres humanos. Somos encomendados por la ley espírita. No tenemos una ley espírita en nuestro plano universal, ¿entiendes? La cual somos plasmados, energía, somos invocados para venir a este plano por medio de un cuerpo físico a hacer las sanaciones a los pacientes con cualquier tipo de problema que tengan ellos a nivel físico, espiritual, sentimental, laboral, profesional, todo lo que necesite ayuda.
在委内瑞拉，许多人认为精神主义者的仪式治疗可以代替传统的医学，也因为没有钱支付传统医疗的服务，许多新冠的患者在感染之后前来寻求帮助。精神治疗师卡洛斯认为，人们因为水、土、火和空气等等的元素失衡，才会不健康。他主张透过精神疗法唤起人们的动力，并且利用这些力量来恢复精神，以达到每个人的能量平衡。不过，这样的方法能不能解决人民内心的痛苦，就见仁见智了。历史上的今天，要带您回到1944年的5月14号。这一天是电影《星际大战》的创作者乔治·卢卡斯的生日。他出生在美国的加州。卢卡斯在中学的时候喜欢上电影，大学时便到洛杉矶的南加大攻读电影学位。后来，为了要得到自由的创作空间，卢卡斯跟另一名导演科波拉一同创造美国活动画片工作室。期间拍摄出哥波拉的代表作《教父》，卢卡斯的喜剧电影《美国风情画》。1971年，卢卡斯成立了卢卡斯影业，并在6年之后，借由参考日本导演黑泽明的电影《战国英豪》，推出了第一部《星际大战》电影四部曲《曙光乍现》。2012年开始，卢卡斯将《星际大战》的版权卖给了迪士尼，创作方向则是转往独立的动画电影。感谢您今天的加入，以上是我们为您整理出来的国际新闻。喜欢我们的朋友，记得要订阅我们，同时要开启订阅小铃铛，让我们继续帮你挖掘好新闻。我们下次见，拜拜。